Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Dorkside Cookies. This is one of our Let's Plays, so we're going to be playing through Arkham Horror, the living card game. This is going to be part one. We're going to record the full campaign, but in this episode, we're doing the Gathering, which is chapter one of Night of the Zealot. All right, so we've got our characters. I'm Roland Banks.
And I am Agnes Baker, the waitress.
I think Agnes Baker's like story is that she's reincarnated. Like maybe she's a witch from the Salem witch trials or something.
Interesting.
Yeah. I'm a Fed. So I've got lots of like federal powers and ability to like, you know, enforce laws with my fists.
My girl, it's mostly her... willful wit?
She uses her assets to get what she wants.
Well, I was saying her... What is that? That's
oh, the her stats? Yeah, you are mostly willpower.
Yeah, willpower.
Because you're magic, I guess.
Yes.
All right. So, Night of the Zealot. The Ghoul's Hunger. Friday, September 18th, 1925. Arkham, Massachusetts. It is the end of a long and abnormally hot summer. The first hints of autumn beckon, but a heavy heat persists relentless. A silent, unspoken anger grips the town. Tempers are short, and in the last week alone, there have been numerous reports of townspeople coming to heated, violent blows with one another over simple misunderstandings. And now, a call from James Hankerson. He claims to have found a dismembered body in his barn. Blaming the weather would be too easy. There is something wrong with this town, and not a whole lot this old soothsayer can do to stop the slide. My auguries indicate a small group of investigators will soon take note of these strange happenings and set forth to make things right. I'll be watching their progress, but I won't be holding my breath. So that's Night of the Zealot. It's a campaign for 1 to 4 players, and it's just the two of us.
Oh. He did not like that this time.
He was just a little scared. We're all about to be scared.
Oh. He's talking about it.
He's definitely part of the show now.
Part one, The Gathering. You and your partners have been investigating strange events taking place in your home city of Arkham, Massachusetts. Over the past few weeks, several townspeople have mysteriously gone missing. Recently, their corpse turned up in the woods, savaged and half-eaten. The police and newspapers have stated that wild animals are responsible, but you believe there is something else going on. You are gathered together at the lead investigator's home to discuss these bizarre events. So we previously decided that it's going to be me. I'm the lead investigator.
For this one.
For this one.
It only makes sense. He's a Fed. I'm a waitress. Yeah. How does that make sense?
All right. So we have set up the game, and we are ready to go. So I'm just going to... Well,
we're
quite
kind
ready
of
to go.
Ready to
yeah,
go.
Yeah, I need to draw 5 cards.
Mm-hmm.
And I need 5 resources, please. Now, per the rules, I drew a madness card. So I'm going to put that to the side, draw another one. And then I'm going to shuffle the madness card back in.
Now, I did not, but did I get an asset? I got 2, 3 assets.
So you can decide. You could still take a mulligan.
Nah.
Okay. So, who wants to go first?
Wait. Well, we first have to read everything.
All right. So we're in the study. We're going to... Technically, like, so, you've been investigating the strange events occurring in Arkham for several days now. Your desk is covered in newspaper articles, police reports, and witness accounts. Flip it. We'll put,
Do we know anything yet? Because the door hasn't...
We haven't read
that piece yet.
All right. Read the agenda.
Yes.
What's going on? It is late at night. You are holed up in your study, researching the bloody disappearances that have been taking place in the region. A few hours into your research, you hear the sound of strange chanting coming from your parlor down the hall. At the same time, you hear dirt churning as if something were digging beneath the floor. So that's agenda 1A.
I'm good at this.
Act 1A, trapped. As you leap to investigate, the door to your study vanishes before your eyes, leaving behind only solid wall. You're trapped inside your study until you can find another way out.
Oh no, we're not trapped in my study. We're trapped in your study. Are you kidding me?
This is a rental. I mean, I thought I put down a safety deposit and I'm gonna have doors, but no.
No, they seem to be disappearing acts.
So we flip it. It says put 4 clues. And the game, at this point, has officially started.
Now, we don't do the mythos on the very first turn, so we get at least one saving grace.
One turn of respite.
All right, so do you have anything that would help you search the room and get yourself anything good?
No. Okay. No, I don't. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do my 3 actions real quick. Flip that. I'm going to do emergency cash, so I get 3 more resources.
Yes.
I'm going to spend 4
to
put
the
out
gun.
The gun, the 45 automatic.
Well, that's nice.
And then
bullets to it.
Let's see here. I will then also put down, so that was 1, 2, and 3. I have some first aid, which can heal damage or horror. The reason why I was intent on putting it out now is if something makes us discard a card, I know I can heal some damage.
Mm-hmm.
And in a previous game, I went insane. So, yeah. Oh, wait. My gun has 4 ammo. And my first aid kit has 3 supplies.
Hmm.
All right. What is Agnes Baker?
Well, I could potentially draw the top card of the encounter deck and then discover 2 clues right there.
That's up to you. It's early on, so... And I have a gun.
That's true.
Oh, wait.
Mm-mm.
Here's the problem.
You're done already with
I'm
yours.
Done. You should do that before.
The next one.
Yeah.
All right. I'm definitely going to... Instead of that, and deals +1 damage.
There's some creepy art here. The shriveling card. I'm not sure. I feel like it's supposed to be implying that she just incinerates somebody's head.
Shrivels it or something, but it does look like it's incinerating. I don't know. But it doesn't really, like, talk too much to it.
You get to use that 4 times, right?
Yeah, but I have the potential of causing myself to go insane.
Which makes you more powerful.
Yeah. Well, I know I want to put this up because I used that last time.
Okay.
So, that was good.
Don't forget you can spend actions to get more resources.
Oh, yes.
Or draw more cards if you want to search for emergency caches or anything like that.
Yeah, I know I'm going to want to do that.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to pull a card. And it's a spell. Use 3 charges. Exhaust and spend 1 charge to look at the top 3 cards of any investigator's deck.
Okay.
Or the encounter deck.
That's
return
cool.
them to the top of that deck in any order. Yeah.
Yep.
And that just stays in my thing though, right? I wouldn't put that up here. Oh, no,
no
I would.
No, it's an asset. Yeah, it has 3 uses.
Okay, I'm going to put that up right away, and that's my 3rd.
Okay.
So that way I can help you out if I need to.
And it does use a spell slot.
It does.
Okay. So no enemies. So we're skipping the enemy phase. Upkeep phase. And we each draw 1 card.
Mm-hmm. And we each get a resource. And I got a holy rosary.
Interesting, interesting. All right. So, Mythos Phase, place one doom on the agenda. All right. And we each draw one card.
I hate you. You had to give me the one that you got the first time around. You have that up.
Mine was an icy ghoul that spawns only in the cellar. There is no cellar yet, so.
So that was just a waste. That's not actually the discard, though.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
You might want to put those aside somewhere. Mine is Dissonant Voices, Revelation. Put the Dissonant Voices into play in your threat area. You cannot play assets or events. Force, at the end of the round, discard it.
There you go.
So I basically can't do anything.
All right. So do you want to go first or should I?
I can't play assets or events. So probably, I guess, just pick a card for me. Because I can't do anything else, right? I can't
investigate.
I could investigate. This is true. I guess I can do that, and then I
also can draw a bunch of cards, or I don't know.
And I get a plus two to that.
Oh, for this one?
Yeah.
Okay.
If I wanted to.
Yep.
Max one committed per skill test, and if this test is successful, I get to draw a card.
Four, and you need a two.
Yep.
So she's using a skill card called Perception.
Yep.
And of course, yeah, you can use your scrying since you don't have a lot of other options.
No, I can't. It's an asset.
No. You can't play an asset. You can use that power, though.
Oh. Well, I got a plus one. Yay.
Wow.
That's unusual.
And then, so you're going to get one clue. Mm-hmm. And your skill card says you get to draw a card.
And I get to draw a card to replace that card. But I got the basic weakness. Haunted. Thanks so much. Added haunted to your threat area, you get a negative one to each of your skills. But then what and what?
You can spend two actions to discard it.
Okay. Well, that was my first action.
Okay. So you can discard it if you want to spend the rest of your turn. Is that your discard pile?
I'm putting it where it says I'm supposed to put it.
Okay.
In my threat area. I don't know. What do you think? Should I get rid of it or? Either way, I have to get rid of it.
Yeah.
It's going to take two actions. And before we have a whole bunch of creatures, I should.
This might be the right time.
Yeah. So I'm just going to spend my two actions and get rid of it.
Okay.
Unfortunately.
Okay. And I will draw a card. I have two actions left. I will draw a card. Machete. This is a really nice card.
But you already have something in your hand.
Yeah, I have two hands, but...
Oh, that's true.
But yeah, no, I kind of want to... I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to investigate. And I'm a three, so I'll discard Barricade, which puts me at four. Plus one.
Yay! That's
so weird.
Sure, you only put one in there? There's only one in there.
All right.
Okay, so now it's resources.
Yep.
So one of these for me, one of these for you. Pick a card.
Draw a card.
Ward of Protection. It's a fast play. When you draw a non-weakness treachery card, cancel the card's revelation effect, then take one horror. But I can use it for any situation.
Yeah. No, that's good.
So that's good. One more of these lovely bastards on there, and take two cards, because we don't have any creatures.
Yep.
But now I have a creature on me.
Frozen in Fear.
Oh, this is the end of the round, though, right?
Yeah, so...
this is now gone.
Scared, yep.
So you get to have that. And I have a creature on me. Yay!
A ghoul minion. You have an evade of three, and it requires a two, so you may just want to evade.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to do that. But
oh, it's a ghoul minion, though, actually. Well, if I attack it and miss, then you will take damage. But I can. That might make sense.
Yeah, I don't know. Because it doesn't get us anything. It didn't get us victory points or anything.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we could just ignore it. All right. You want to go first?
Sure. And this allows me to put one more to my...
Evade?
Evade, so I'm going to do that.
Okay.
So I have four dig at deep. Least. Dig deep. Negative one. So I'm glad I did that. Because that gave me four.
No, you still would have passed.
Maybe, yeah.
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 But okay, so you're disengaged.
Yep.
And it's just hanging out there for
it
the moment.
It has nothing else to do.
Hopefully we don't get any events that make that ghoul do stuff.
Stop talking.
All right. So that was one action.
That was one action. And then... Do you want me to draw the top card so I can discover two clues in my location?
Yeah.
Okay. It's another goddamn ghoul.
Okay, it spawns on you. That's actually perfect. That's beautiful.
Okay. And then I get two clues, so now we're done.
Okay, so at any time, you can spend clues to advance the agenda. So let's just go ahead and advance. You still have one action left, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we spend four clues. And we flip the card. You notice that the edges of your newly purchased rug are tattered and mud-stained. Finding this odd, you shift the furniture aside and pull back the rug. To your surprise, you see the door leading out of your study. You slowly turn the knob and the door swings open, revealing your hallway below.
Below?
Yeah, we... It's under the rug.
How in the world did you... rent this house and it's now underneath us?
That doesn't even make sense.
You know. You jump through the doorway, landing on your feet on soft dirt. The door to the study slams shut above you. The smell of burning wood fills the narrow hall, intermingled with the scent of rot and decay. Discard each enemy in the study. Bye-bye, ghouls.
Bye-bye. Oh, we got nothing for this.
So we are now in the hallway. That's it. All right.
We don't know anything about anything else? Just the hallway?
The barrier.
Yeah, this is it.
A glowing barrier blocks the path to your parlor. As you move toward it, intense heat forces you to back away. Picking up a handful of dirt, you toss it at the barrier and watch in horror as the dirt incinerates. Perhaps... there's something in the cellar or attic that can help. Objective: when the round ends, investigators in the hallway may, as a group, spend the requisite number of clues to advance.
They may.
So we need six clues, and we must be in the hallway to spend them.
So it's very specific now.
Yeah.
And I still have one more action that I can do. After all that.
So he cannot move into the parlor at this point.
No.
Because the roll's on the parlor card.
That's why it's off to the side, guys.
Yeah. All right, so you still have one action left.
I know.
You can move.
I know.
And then I'll come join you.
I know. I think I'm gonna move to the cellar.
Okay. So
that was the first person to come in here,
though. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So we have to read it.
Your cellar seems to have been replaced with an underground network of icy tunnels and caverns. The cold chills you to the core. What about my old, pictures?
What pictures?
Oh. The stuff I put in my cellar.
But we also, as soon as you enter, you get one damage.
Oh, one damage.
Mm-hmm. Boom. Thank you. All
right. Now, I move down there, and I get one damage.
Oy bay.
All right. There is four clues down here.
Aha. Uh-huh.
And the threshold is four, so it's pretty rough.
I really
need to find some of my things that help me with investigating. I know I left my magnifying glass down here somewhere. So first action was to move. Wait. I'm frozen in fear. Mm-hmm. So actually my first two actions was to move.
Ew.
My third action will be to draw a card. A knife. All of my combat cards, people. I do not need a knife, two guns, training and boxing. Like,
you shuffled your own deck, so.
I know. That was my mistake. Okay, it's the end of my turn. I now get to make a willpower test to get rid of frozen in fear. I really do not want to stay frozen in fear. So I'm gonna do guts. It gives me plus two, and if I'm successful, I get to draw a card. So I'm at five.
I'm the keeper.
Of chaos. Death.
Yeah.
This is minus X, where X is the number of ghouls at my location. There are no ghouls, so it's minus zero. I pass.
You pass.
And so I get to draw a card.
I'll take that. Now that's the difference between standard and hard and expert. If we would have gotten this on the hard and expert, it was negative two. You fail after the skill test. If you fail after the skill test, search the encounter deck and discard pile for a ghoul enemy.
Which there's ghouls.
Are you kidding me? Oh my god.
All right. So that was my turn. I am no longer frozen in fear. That's good.
Yay.
And it is the upkeep phase, so draw a card.
One of those for you. I get an unexpected courage, which gets me two somethings.
Two anythings, yep.
Yep.
Cool.
So that's neat.
Mythos.
Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs.
All right, the agenda is going to advance.
No bueno.
Your house continues to change before your very eyes. The walls have decayed, and the ground in many rooms has turned to dirt. It is almost as if you have been transported somewhere else entirely, although every now and again, you recognize elements of your former home. The lead investigator must decide. Either each investigator discards one card at random from his or her hand, or the lead investigator takes two horror. Now, I don't have a lot of sanity, as it is. I work for the government, so.
He's gonna make us discard one, that's what's gonna happen.
I'm gonna make us discard one.
And now you have all your weapons in there.
Yeah, but I have a weapon equipped, so I'm not too worried. Please knife.
No,
physical training. It's fine.
And my ward of protection.
Could have been worse.
Could have been a lot worse.
Okay.
All right, but we still have to take the mythos cards. Don't we?
Did I what?
When did you cast a spell that lets you take the clue token? Was that from before? Before we left the study?
Yeah.
Okay, just want to make sure.
That was during the study time.
Okay.
Not any other time.
So, Rise of the Ghouls. Agenda 2. The floor beneath you is giving way, and you see a vast network of tunnels twisting into the darkness below. Shapes and silhouettes of strange creatures move swiftly through the tunnels, trying to find a way up. You probably don't want to be here when they do. The agenda is now 7.
And we need to take this.
And we need to take one of these, yep.
Grasping hands. I have to test my evade. For each point you fail by, I have to take a damage. So I have to test my evade. So I have 3. I need to have 3 to evade it.
And the average is -2, I think.
Well, now that means I have to use this, unfortunately, unless you have something.
I could give you a 1.
Okay, that would give me... This gives me, if I take and use 2 here, and then so I can keep this one for something bigger, mm-hmm. that would give me 2, and that's 5, and that's 6.
Okay.
So that's a pretty good chance, maybe.
Yeah. There's one token for failure. Well, two tokens for failure.
All right, stop talking.
He doesn't believe in it.
Nope.
Oops. Negative two.
All right, so you pass.
I pass.
Nothing happens?
No, but if I had failed, for each failure, I would have taken one damage.
Okay.
Decaying hands rise from below.
So I get a swarm of rats.
No way. Of course you do.
Oh, I'm not doing anything yet. You can go first if you want.
Oh, I have to flip me though. Surely there has to be something good here. Oh, draw the top card of the encounter deck. Oh, this is the one that is gone.
Okay.
Yeah, that was the one that was gone. Sorry about that, guys. I had an extra card in my hand. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick a card, mm-hmm. any card. And instead I got Blinding Light. It's an evade kind of thing, which is not very helpful. But what I would like to do is try to search, but I only could possibly get four from that. So I can't really search in this room because I won't pass. Okay, the chances of passing
keep looking for some sort of plus something. Book, I guess.
Yep. If I have one.
Is that your turn?
Oh, no, that was my first.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to grab another, and it's my lucky rabbit's foot. And because I like my lucky rabbit's foot, and I've used it before, and my other jewelry is this one, so I could either put my holy rosaries up, which gets me a plus one to my will, mm-hmm. or I could have a, if I fail a skill test, I can grab a card.
I love the rabbit's feet, personally.
Yeah, me too. So that's what I'm going to use, which means then this can just get discarded when I need to.
Yeah.
So there's my, that was one, two, and three.
Cool.
So I'm done. Your turn.
All right. I'm going to stomp the rats.
Stomp them?
Yeah.
Stomp.
I have a four. I need a one.
Not wrong. And, of course, you got the tentacles, which we don't have a symbol for over here. So I think that was one of the ones we had to look up with the tentacles.
I think it's an automatic failure. Counts as a zero.
I think so, too, but I can't remember.
Yeah.
Which kind of sucks that you stomped without stomping.
I'm glad I didn't spin any cards, though, because...
That would have sucked.
That would have sucked. Skill, maybe chaos symbols. Six. Autofill.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay. So autofill.
No stomping. What he did is he stomped the ground thinking that's where the rats were.
All right. I stomped them again.
Stomp.
Okay. Perfect. No ghouls. I kill it. As part of my action, when I kill a monster, I get to discover one clue at my location.
Mm-hmm.
So that was two actions. And for my third action, I will draw a card.
Makes sense.
All right, good. Dr. Milan Christopher.
Is that your librarian?
No. Mm. I discarded the librarian to help you.
No.
Dr. Milan Christopher gives me a plus one book.
Oh.
So he's amazing. He's one of the two cards I was looking for. So I think we're going to be a lot better now.
That's similar to my Holy Rosaries, where I get a plus one to my willpower.
Except... After I successfully investigate, I get to gain a resource, too.
I hate you. It's your house. You have me trapped in your house.
So I stomped the rat twice, and then I drew a card.
Yes.
So that's it.
So we get to draw another card.
All right.
And get a resource. You just are piling on over there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards. So, all right. Ready for the first Mythos token of the new agenda?
Boom, yeah. And I'm frozen in fear.
Okay. Another Doom token. Ancient Evils.
Damn it. So we already know that the first time I perform one of the following actions, move, fight, or evade, it's going to end up being... it costs an additional action. But I can investigate, it looks like.
Yep.
And not have it count as anything. So that's nice. Or draw a card.
Cool.
Because literally move, fight, or evade.
Yeah.
So.
It's not really that bad. All right. So if you don't mind, I'll just go first. Yeah. I'm excited. Spend 4.
Uh-oh.
To put out Dr. Milan, Christopher. Right? Now I'm at 4 books, which is at least equal with the seller. Man, do I investigate? This is a hard place to investigate. I mean, it's just not easy. If I get rid of my gun, then I will be at 5.
I could give you 2 by discarding this.
I don't know if we want to do that. But if you had a +1 book, no?
I do, but it's scavenging.
Is that something you want?
If I...
No, that's pretty nice.
If I put it up there, then I can grab something out of my discard pile. Which we would like to be able to do every once in a while.
So my first action was Dr. Milan Christopher. I'm going to draw a card.
That's 2.
Great. And then my third action will be to investigate. I'm going to discard evidence. That puts me at
6. He's incinerating 6. It.
That puts me at 6. Yeah, I'm just going to try it.
Oh! -4.
But if I had discarded more cards, I would not have been able to pass. Basically, no. For me, at this point in the game, there's no way for me to pass.
Well, do you want to move up?
I'm done.
To maybe the afterwards, maybe move up to the attic. Maybe it's going to be easier. I don't know.
We got to get this, though. That's the problem. Yeah. So if something appears, if a monster appears, I can get clues by killing it.
Yeah,
so
that's true.
All right. Do you still have actions?
I still have actions. Okay. I did not get to do mine, I don't think. All right, I am going to, let's see, what does the frozen say I'm not allowed to do? I can't move, fight, or evade, basically. So I can move this guy up here and spend 1. So at least if by chance I do anything. Are you in particularly looking for anything in your deck?
I am.
So I'm going to spend 1 of these to look at the top 3 of your car and return them in any order.
So I'm looking for anything that helps my investigate, of course. Ideally magnifying glass.
Yeah, that's not going to work out for you. But, so I have that and then willpower or evade after that.
Let's say willpower. Why not?
Okay. And that. And this is the order in which
that makes me sad. For the next 3 cards, I will not get a bonus to investigate.
I didn't say that. It's just not your magnifying glass.
No, it has to be permanent. It can't be a card to discard.
It's a card basically to discard.
Because I already threw away 2.
So that was 2.
Okay.
And then I'm going to... Should I pick up a resource or should I pick up a card? I really want to be able to investigate and I don't have anything.
Maybe you
right
need
now.
To go to the attic.
Maybe.
Because.
Well, I can't move right now because of this.
Yeah, exactly.
It's going to screw me. So.
You drew a card?
I guess that's what I just did. If this skill test is successful, heal 1 horror.
Okay.
Innate. So. If this skill test...
It's a skill card.
Okay.
So if you spend it on a willpower check.
Ah, yeah. Which I will be doing in a few minutes. But I don't have any horror, so I don't really think that that's a good use of that. All right. That is the end of my turn. So I get to grab one of these and this, which is awesome.
Okay. So, you know, flashlight is pretty cool. That is pretty decent.
I told you it wasn't going to be necessarily what you're looking for, but it's not a bad thing.
Okay. And that's it. Doom token?
Doom.
Please, rats. I need rats.
Instead, it's dissonated voices. Oh, no. Don't I have to do this before I pull another one of these?
Oh, yeah. At the end of your turn, technically.
All right. So, let's see. Willpower. No, I don't want to use that willpower. But it is the death. The skull, which there are no ghouls, so it does nothing to me. So it's basically a zero, which means I am successful, and that is gone.
Nice.
Unfortunately, though. No, but I did spend that to get six, so. Yeah, okay, now I have Desonate. Or Desonate Voices. Voices. Sucks. All right.
So I have a ravenous ghoul. It's pretty tough.
A what?
A ravenous ghoul.
Oh, wait, there was a ghoul in play? Oh, no, that.
Just now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. All righty. Let's shoot it.
Absolutely.
Use it up in ammo. That puts me at 5 fight. I need a 3.
Yeah.
I will discard a knife to put me to 6.
Okay.
And this is plus 1 damage.
I didn't shake it, so you're gonna mix them around a little bit. There you go.
0.
Yay!
So I did 2 damage to it.
Oh, but it's still alive.
Still alive. That was my first action. Second action, I will. Do I punch it? I'm just at 4 if I just punch it. And it's at 3. That's plus 1. But the odds are -2. I'm gonna have to shoot it again.
Poor gun.
Yeah. Oops.
What did you do? Pull 2?
Yeah, I accidentally pulled 2. -1.
Yay!
Alright. My special ability means I get a clue.
I don't know why you gave these to me. It's on your side, Bucky. Yeah,
so it's 2 actions. My third action will be to equip the flashlight.
Nice. And what does that do for you?
That gives me the ability to spend
how many do you need?
3.
Oh.
3 battery usages.
Oh, now they're batteries.
So I can spend a battery to get -2 shroud. So this will be 2 for an investigation. So that's pretty good.
So I cannot play assets or events, and unfortunately, emergency cash is an event, so I can't use it. So
we know the ghoul priest is coming up. You may want to prepare by either drawing cards or getting resources. You're very low on resources, so you can't spend much on your dig deeps. I know you have the card that's going to give you 3 resources in a moment, but...
Yeah, maybe next time.
Yeah.
So then I got my other one. Yay! Okay, so then I'm going to pick and get 2 resources because that's basically all I can do right now.
Okay.
Because of the stupid voices in my head.
So we each get a card?
I've got paranoia going on. And make sure you only have 8.
Yeah, I'm only at 6, so I've been...
I have flashlight now.
Wow, you actually are at 8.
Yeah.
Oh, you have your flashlight. So now you could actually possibly investigate the cellar or go go up to the attic and be super easy.
Mm-hmm. Well, we don't know if the attic is super easy. We hope that the attic is super easy. Yeah, I mean, my next one, I'm going to do a move and then spend some of that awesome stuff to get more resources.
Doom token?
Doom, doom, doom. That's four dooms on the seven.
Yeah.
Obscuring fog. Damn it. Attached location gets plus two. I swear to God, nothing we... Oh, I can't go up there now. This room is going to suck.
Why?
Obscuring
fog. Oh, but it's just canceled out, right? Before, so I can spin a flashlight and it'll just cancel it.
Oh, okay.
So it's okay. It's not great.
And this goes away finally. I got both of those damn things this time.
Okay. You wanna go first? You could just... So that enemy is up there, and it's worth one victory point.
I know, we're gonna have to fight it
no matter what. No, but no, you don't have to fight it. It's not even a ghoul. No, it is a ghoul. So that's the only thing, is if you go up there and you ignore it, but then you draw the broken shield token, then it's gonna do damage.
Exactly. Now I don't have a lot of damage. So what I would like to do is to spend one of my caches to get three. That's my first. And then, and I guess then move up there, because...
Yep, that's it.
That's two movement and I'm done. I somehow managed to get through the fog. To get up there. So now I'm sitting and hanging out with this. Oh,
well,
wait.
You gotta flip it.
And we have to flip it. Forced, after you enter the attic, take one whore, and he's going to explain why.
The bloody carcass of a malformed beast swings from a meat hook chained to the ceiling.
But that means, because I took it after I entered there, guess what? He automatically gets damage.
Good call.
Because that's her power.
You can even leave and come back.
I know.
Next turn.
Next turn.
blood drains slowly from the carcass, dripping into a small barrel. So there's this monster, this flesh eater. He's living up in the attic, and he's got something, someone maybe, hanging from a meat hook, draining into a barrel.
It's like one of the worst horror movies ever.
No, I'm sure there's much worse.
Yeah, I'm sure.
All right, so you're done.
Yeah, that was my third, and then I actually got to damage the guy, so now he's down to three damage left.
Very nice.
I know.
Alrighty. So...
I know what I'm doing next time.
I had wanted to investigate, but right now, I break even. This is horrible from a turn economy, but... No, I only do plus one damage, so even if I... No, okay, wait. Put four clues there?
Oh, yes. There is four clues there. That's not clues, though.
Yeah.
I mean, all we need are six, so we have two left here. This is worth something. It's worth a victory point.
It is, yeah.
But we should really get rid of that first. Because you're going
to
get
but
one.
But then I have to spend so much... I have to spend two movement just moving
up.
And then later on, two movement to come back down.
I know. So it's really up to you how you want to do it.
It
would be better if you stayed here. And then I can just use this unexpected courage to help you.
Okay, I'm going to investigate.
Okay, and this...
You're not at the location.
Damn it.
Yeah. You know, I'm going to draw a card.
Makes sense. Actually,
it didn't help me at all?
No.
Okay. I'm going to investigate twice in a row.
Yeah. But you have that awesome flashlight that you could spend if you needed to.
Yes.
Oh.
I've never drawn the Eldritch symbol. Plus one for each clue. So I got plus two, so it gave me a six. So I easily passed the threshold, which means this is gone.
And you get a clue token.
Actually, I barely passed, just technically, but still, anyway.
But did you have anything up there that has anything to do with investigating where
yeah,
you
yeah, so I'm going to tap Dr. Milan Christopher,
okay,
which gets a resource.
Nice.
And you get a clue. One of those. And now, for my third action, I will spend one from the flashlight.
Okay.
And now, that makes this a 2, and I am 4. It's not guaranteed, but...
There's a good chance, though.
Average odds. Done.
Done. And that means that this goes into our victory pile. That's not a victory, but this does have a victory, and I'm just putting it in the finished pile.
All right.
For reals.
So my turn's done. Real. And
you're kind of not in any place.
Yeah, I know.
I.
You kind of took that away.
I took it away. Here, we'll put it back like this. Okay. There you go. All
right.
He's
so
hanging out.
Defeated the cellar.
Yep.
And what do we have? How many do we need? We only need six.
Two more, so we should really defeat that if we can. If we have the chance.
Yeah.
I mean, it's only a 1, so now I could actually investigate along with you. So, anyways.
Yeah, you got a flashlight if you want or whatever.
And resources. All right,
so...
So I'm going to grab a card and I grabbed a resource. I got Forbidden Knowledge. That's nice. Awesome, because that's going to be helpful.
I do like that card.
Me too. As long as I don't get any shit from there.
Oh, deduction. That's a good card.
All right, so we add a mythos. You get one, I get one. And I have a grasping hands again. How is it that I keep getting repeats? And you got obscuring fog. So
oh, that's
just
fine.
Oh, yeah, because it's on yours.
On my location.
Damn. All right, so I have to do a test here. And I have plenty of resources now. So I have 3 there.
So if you can do 1 damage, I can kill the Flesh Eater this turn.
Excellent.
If you can't do 1 damage, then I'm going to investigate.
Okay, I've got... I have to do this right now, right? Before it's my turn? Mm-hmm. I have to do this before my turn.
Revelations, yeah, immediately.
Okay, so I'm going to spend one of these. Because it's not really anything.
So it's 4.
That gives me 4. I'm going to spend 2 of these. That gets me 6.
On Dig Deep?
Yeah, using Dig Deep.
Okay, so 5, 6.
So the hope is that I beat it. And
that's
it did.
4. So
it did. Cool. So that's all I care about. Yeah, it seems like a worthless amount of my resources, but I have another one right there.
And that's the mythos phase, right?
That was the mythos phase.
All right.
So you're down below.
Yep.
I am... You wanted me to try to attack him?
If you can deal 1 damage somehow, whether you take horror damage and then ping him for 1, but basically he has 4 life and I do 2 damage. So...
I could do these 2. I really want to put this up here, so I'm going to put that up there.
Okay.
For 4. Because that's going to help us, I think, with the big guy. See, if forbidden knowledge has no secrets, discard it, exhaust forbidden knowledge, and take 1 whore. Then I'm going to exhaust it to take 1 whore, which does what again?
Allows you to ping him for 1 damage.
And that's what you wanted, right?
That's it.
There we go. I did it for you, so that's 2.
And what did that do for you?
What it does is it basically allows me to take this and add it to 1 secret. Oh, I forgot to put it into my pile, actually. Exhaust forbidden knowledge and take 1 whore, move 1 secret from the forbidden knowledge to my resource.
Awesome.
So actually, I should put that one back in
there.
But
it's exhausted now, right?
Yeah, it's exhausted now, so I can't use it again.
It has 3 uses or 2 uses?
It has 4 uses altogether,
right.
And now it has 3.
And then how many actions do you have left?
I have 1 more.
Okay.
So then I'm going to use my other resources.
Okay.
And put that up, because I think I'm going to need those, and I don't want to lose that card by some randomness.
Okay. And then...
Hopefully I don't get anything that causes me to lose it.
For my turn, move, move.
and fight.
What's up with the monster up here?
I'm sorry. It was just here. I can't do anything.
That's a monster. I've got to put it down. So I shoot it with my 45 automatic.
Woohoo!
And so that's going to put me at 5 and do 2 damage. I need a 4, though. So let's...
You don't want to get rid of another weapon just in case.
So I have a machete. So I'm going to decide which weapon do I want to end the game with. And I'm going to say, I'm going to end with a machete.
Yeah, that's good
so,
stuff.
So I'm going to discard Roland's. It's 1 combat, plus it's an innie. So I'm going to have 2 combat.
Okay.
So that's going to put me at 6-7. So I have 7 against its 4.
All right.
Damn it.
And you got a negative 4.
Why? All right.
All that work.
And now it's going to do damage to me.
Because you engaged it?
Because I engaged it.
Really?
Yeah.
My little guys didn't do anything like... Oops, sorry, guys. So my little guys didn't do anything. When I accidentally got damage onto it, it didn't do anything to it?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine.
That sucks balls. So,
enemy phase. He's going to attack me. I'm going to play dodge. I'm going to pay 1 to cancel his attack.
Okay.
And I'll just have to kill him next turn.
It's fine. All right. Grab a card and a resource. Here's your resource. I got perception this time. So that's 2 for investigating, which I would want to do if all goes well today.
Okay.
All right. Put one of these on there. There's currently 6. Rotting remains. I have to do test 3. For each point, I fail 1 horror. What do you got? Add a doom token?
Yeah.
Damn
so
you.
So just go ahead and finish yours before.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So in some ways, I don't want to get any horror damage, but in other ways, if I take horror damage, he gets hurt.
It is a new round.
By 1. So, 1 or more, I can deal 1 damage, limit 1 per phase.
Yep.
Okay, so, but I really don't want to if I don't have to. So I get 5 here.
This is what Fearless is for, right?
Fearless? Fearless, yeah. If this skill is successful, I heal 1 horror. So yeah, that would be good actually to use. So we're going to put that on top of it. So that gets me 6.
Versus 3.
Versus 3. And I don't trust it because you showcased that negative 4. So that's 6. And I'm going to spend 2 of these to use my deep dig because I just don't trust it. No.
Wait, how far did you go?
So 5, 6, 7, 8. No?
Because you only want to go 4? To 4 higher because there's only a negative
4. Oh, yeah, 4. Yeah, that makes sense. So I'll just spend 1. Me no good at math, I guess.
It's a curve. Once you get that master's degree, it goes downhill.
And there is a ghoul in here.
So you take 1 damage.
I take 1 damage.
Yeah.
Pass it around, but I still pass.
Yeah.
So that did nothing to me. Except I got damaged. So now I'm at 4 and 6.
Okay. And you healed 1, right? Because you used Fearless?
Oh, yeah. And I heal 1 sanity.
Yeah.
That's right. Good call.
All right. Ancient Evils. Doom Token.
And that flips it. Boom. You gotta read that, right? Nope.
A feral beast, roughly humanoid, with a canine cast and hooves for feet, tears through the ground in front of you. Below the floor, you can see vast tunnels beneath your house. Fiendish howling echoes from deep within the underground caverns. Shuffle the discard pile into the encounter deck. Discard cards from the top until a ghoul enemy is discarded. The lead investigator draws that enemy.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. We have 10 rounds until Maybe 10 rounds, maybe less than that.
Ghoul.
Oh, ghoul minion, that's at least better.
Yeah. Alrighty, well.
Alright, is there anything you can do to take horror damage?
Oh, I can.
You know what, I might as well just shoot. I might as well just shoot. I'll just shoot, that's fine. So, I shoot him.
You shoot who?
The flesh eater.
Okay.
And so that gives me 4, 5. That's it? 5? 5 versus 4? No, I better shoot the ghoul minion. I better shoot the ghoul minion. So, 3 ahead.
Yeah, because I'm going to damage that other guy on my turn.
+1.
Yay!
Apparently I should have killed the flesh eater. But I kill the ghoul minion, which lets me take a clue.
Yay!
Okay. That was my first action. Then... You can't do 2 damage to this guy, though, can you?
No, but I can do 1 damage.
Okay. I'm going to draw a card, just in case. Damn it! Why?
Discard all your resources. Oh my god.
Paranoia. What was that noise?
Bye-bye resources.
I hate this card, guys.
At least you don't have 2 in there anymore.
All right, so I have 1 action left. I have no ammo. I do have a weapon. Can't pay for it anymore. So that's great. Oh yeah, he's back. I could just investigate.
I think that would be good for you.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to investigate. I will spend a flashlight.
Okay.
Oh, wait. I really don't want damage, though. And if I attack it and win, then I could... then you might be able to kill it.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't. I'll just be at 4, and it's 4 versus 4. I could win, but it's not likely. Okay, no, that's fine. I'll investigate.
Okay.
Spend a flashlight. That puts it at a -1. I'm at a 4. So I can only lose on a tentacle.
Why do you say such things?
Okay. So I investigate.
And what's that do for you?
I exhaust him and I get 1 resource.
Okay.
Which helps me pay for the machete.
And then here you go. So now we have enough of those, but do we want to just finish the room off since...
This guy's going to kill me. I can't...
You can't stay there.
Yeah, you could leave, I guess.
Well, I'm going to damage him.
Okay.
Gives me another resource.
How is that?
Because I can't...
So you spend an action to get money?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's the same as if I were to spend money up there, right?
Oh, but you took horror damage that way?
Yeah.
Okay, so you damaged him that way.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I should do, right?
That's perfect.
And then, let's see. I could have 3 fight there, and...
You could obliterate him with Shrivel.
Shrivel?
That's your attack spell. You're more powerful than me.
Yeah, but I have to put it up there. But I already have 1 in here.
Get rid of Scrying.
How do I get rid of it?
Just discard it.
Oh, okay. I can just discard it
that?
Yeah. Those go away, though. Okay, so I did 1. I'm going to spend that for 3.
Yep.
And that gets me 4 charges. And then I can spend 1 charge fight. This attack uses willpower instead of that and deals 1 damage. That's all I really need. So I'm going
to
spend...
And you get to spend dig deep.
Yes.
That's awesome.
So I'm going to move these over. So everybody can see what's going on here.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm going to spend 1 of these, and then that gets me... So that's 5 instead of 2. So 5. And then... then where is it? And then I can do him for 6 and 7. 6?
Yes.
6 and 7, right? I should go to 7 at least.
Yes. So you're 3 higher than him.
And I am now 3 higher than him?
Yep. If you fail, I take damage. It's fine. I have plenty of hit points.
But wait. It takes 4 to fight him.
Yep.
I'm at 5, 6, 7, 8. I should do 8 just in case it's a -4, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I'm going to spend 3 for that.
Okay.
And that also makes that one exhausted as well. And
whew.
I take 1 Nothing. Damage, right? The number of ghoul enemies in your...
No, it just means -1.
Oh, and so he is dead then, right?
He's dead.
He's dead.
Good job, wizard.
And we get a victory point for that. Now that is my entire move, right?
That was everything.
Because I discarded to get this thing. Okay. Okay, so there we go. And this goes back in there.
All right, enemy phase, no enemies.
No enemies.
Upkeep phase, draw a card.
Draw a card, get a resource. Here is a little resource for you there. Cunning distraction. I automatically evade all enemies in my location if I wanted to use that.
Very nice, very nice.
But it's gonna cost me 5 resources to use it. I don't know if I wanna do that. So do we wanna finish investigating in here or do we want to,
because? We have to, no, we don't have to. We could end the objective barrier.
Okay.
So
first, we have to put this on here.
Yeah, right? Let's do that.
Damn grasping hands. You have rotting remains and I have grasping hands.
Yeah, well, I don't like willpower checks, so this is
end up not being exhausted anymore. So that actually is not exhausted. So all right, so I need feetsies. I only have 3 feetsies. I'm gonna spend 2 feetsies. This sucks. So that gets me 5 feetsies.
Oh.
And I got one of those.
Oh, very nice.
So +1 for each whore on Agnes.
Okay.
So I have 2, and I totally defeat that
thing. Very nice. I'm going to discard guts, and that puts me at 5. -3 puts me at 2,
mm-hmm.
which means I take 1 horror, but I'm actually going to put that on Dr. Milan Christopher.
Okay.
Because it doesn't kill him.
And he has 2 anyways. He just went a little more nuts.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so now we're back up to the top. So what exactly do you want to do?
I have all this stuff for investigating.
So do I.
I have deduction, which means if I'm successful, I get another clue.
Okay, why don't you try that?
Yeah, so I'm going to spend my last flashlight.
Okay.
Because I'm probably going to get a machete in a moment. I'm going to spend deduction.
Okay.
So that puts it at, that's -1, and this is 3, so there's only the tentacle.
Well, that's true.
-3. So I pass, and I get 1 additional clue. Oops, he's blonde. So 1 additional clue, and I exhaust that to get a resource.
Okay. Which so means this room is done now.
Yep. So that was done. And then I'm going to move here.
And
I have all the clues.
I know. This time I wasn't able to get anything.
But
I was not pulling luck.
But we can't spin until the end of the round.
Right.
So I still have 1
action. That's what the card had said.
Yeah, exactly. So I have 1 clue left. I mean, one clue. I have 1 action left. This is what I just got, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So do you want to get another resource so you can put your machete out, or? Or just put your machete out.
I'm just going to put my machete out.
Okay. That makes sense.
And I'm going to discard my flashlight because
it's no longer useful.
Actually, yeah, it's just no longer useful.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to move down because I have to. And that makes this is a victory point, so I'm putting you down with my victories. Yay! And then I guess that's my only move there. So what I think I'm going to do is just prepare at this point.
Yeah.
This would allow me to evade anything that's there. if something were to happen, but I don't know if that's really necessary. And these basically do nothing for me at this point.
It's a very expensive event, but it might be necessary. Who knows?
This event? Yeah. We'll see if, worst case scenario. I have this where I could put this up there. Do I have... Oh, but I already have a necklace, so that's not really helpful. So basically what I'm going to want to do is get a card, which is lucky. So I get +2 to my skill value if I were to fail it. So that's probably good. So I got this, lucky.
Yep.
So it's just a fast play, so I can just use it if I need to. And then I have one more thing I can do. So should I just get another resource or should I get another card?
Card? Well, I don't know. Is there a card that you know that would help you? Because if there's not, then you should get a resource. So you can spend it more on Dig Deep.
I think at this point, there's only one other card that would be helpful, and that'd be fighting.
Okay.
But...
I think your fighting is all going to be from Dig Deep, because it's all willpower.
Yeah. No.
For shriveling.
Oh, if I were to use this, yes, definitely.
You have 3 attacks left.
So. Yeah, I should do that, definitely.
You hear a crazed howl outside, and suddenly all the creatures turn their attention to that sound. They rush to escape the house, breaking down doors and clawing at everything in their way. So all it's saying is at the end of each enemy phase, each unengaged ghoul, which there have not been any yet, move towards the parlor.
And this is the parlor at this point. It moves towards it. Does it enter it?
If it gets to the parlor, then at the end of the round, place one doom on the agenda for each ghoul that's in the hallway or the parlor.
Okay.
So effectively...
we don't want to be over there.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so my turn is done. Now it's just yours. Turn. Oh, why didn't you turn these in?
We can't till the end of the round.
Oh, did you just move there?
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
So this is now the end of the round.
Okay, I got confused. Sorry, it's getting late.
Yeah. All right, so...
Upkeep
phase. Draw a card. Magnifying glass. Now that I don't need it.
Another unexpected courage. That's super useful for later.
All right, and now I spend the clue tokens.
Yes.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Clue tokies.
Flip the card. Using the barrel from the attic, you carry ice and snow from the cellar and hurl it at the barrier. The barrier sparks and shudders as it consumes the ice, then hisses and fades out of existence. The barrier blocking passage into the parlor has vanished. Reveal the parlor.
Boom. And...
Okay, it says, put it the set aside Lita Chandler into play in the parlor.
Yep, got her right here.
Spawn the set aside ghoul priest in the hallway.
Okay.
Okay. It's not engaged with anybody at this point.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, as near as I can tell. Definitely, if somebody knows otherwise, I'd love it for them to post down below.
It will, though. It's a hunter, so it's going to attack one of us.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
In the enemy phase.
Because I have the highest stuff.
But the enemy phase is already done, right?
Yeah, this was at the end of the round.
So. Yeah, so you have the investigate phase, which you might want me to go into this room and get her.
Probably. Okay, one moment. Act 3A.
Oh, darn it.
What have you done? A woman with a torch stands in her parlor, a glimmer of hatred in her eyes. What have you done to my barrier? She screams, furious. Before you can answer, a ghastly wail sounds behind you, and a creature wearing robes and a deer skull mask tears through the wall, advancing toward you. If the ghoul priest is defeated, advance.
Yes.
So no more clue tokens. We're done with that crap.
All right,
now,
so
time for the machete.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the parlor and I have to do a four
now, just for everybody at home, the ghoul priest has 5 hit points per number of players, so it has 10 hit points.
Yeah.
Also, it's a hunter, which means even though we're not engaged, it will come for us. Number 2, it has retaliate. If we fail an attack, it attacks us.
So it's really important for me to get Lolita because she will provide one fight and one damage. So it's very important for me to get her.
Yeah.
And lucky for me, I have all these lovely cards to help me. So I need to get...
So she wants you to parlay.
Parlay. So she has four books, and I now have three plus my two, which is six. That only gives me a plus two. I'm going to have to use one of these as well then.
You
do. So I have one, two, three, four, five. Plus my two is seven. And if I were to fail it, I can use that.
Okay, great.
So that's seven, right?
Yep.
Okay.
So one action to move here. Second action to parlay.
Parlay. And I only got a negative one, so I was successful.
So you take control of Lita Chandler. She occupies your body slot.
Yes. So now she is mine, and then I go back.
Third action.
So that he can use it. This is the part of the cooperation that you want to be utilizing.
Right. So Lita Chandler gives plus one hit and plus one damage.
Yes.
I do have a machete. I have three actions.
No, the machete does what for you again?
The machete gives me plus one attack, and if this is the only enemy I'm engaged with, plus one damage. Did we do the top of the round, though?
Yeah, we did. That's...
We didn't.
We didn't? I thought I did because I had a card here. Didn't we get these two horrible things?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because these appeared.
And it threw us off.
It threw us off. Sorry, guys.
Oh.
Okay, so let's just resolve this, and if it's crazy, then we'll have to undo it.
Okay.
Wait, though, you can't do it. Put it back. No, what?
Hey. What? No, because I already looked at them.
Yeah, but there's a particular order.
There's not a particular order to them.
But you don't know what they are. That's the important thing. Unless you memorize it in that order. Here you go. And here you go.
I did put them in an order. I knew exactly what I got. And now I can't do any assets or events. Because you suck.
It's one round. I'll just have to survive the one round. I just want to win legitimately. And if you end up running out of the house screaming...
No, that's not the first time.
It's not the first time. Okay. Wait, why can't you... You can totally do everything you did.
Assets and events?
It's parlay.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I investigated and moved.
So everything you did is still valid.
Okay.
So you went there, parlayed, you came back.
Okay.
You ignore the voices. There's obscuring fog, which doesn't matter because there's no clue tokens in the hallway. Boom. Okay.
We're still okay.
We're still okay.
However, I am going to hurt myself in the next one.
On purpose.
On purpose.
Yeah. All right. So.
Just not yet.
Did I really get rid of my gun?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, that's fine.
Machete was more important.
It is. I just wanted more stuff to discard. Okay.
I can give you plus two. That's what I can give you. Or I can give you plus one.
Okay. So right now, with her plus one, I'm going to be at 4, 5, 6 versus his 4. So I really need at least a plus one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So yeah, that one would be great.
This one or this one?
That one, I think. Because that's just plus one. That puts me at negative 3.
Yep.
Or, I mean, 3 above.
Okay.
Negative 1. Okay, great.
Got it.
So I did 1.
Oh, and you
plus
forgot
Plus 1
her.
Is 2.
Anyways.
Plus 1 is 3. 3 damage.
Well, there. Yep.
To the gold priest. That was my first attack.
Yes.
Second attack, I'm at 4, 5, 6. I guess that's it.
I could use this, but yeah.
We still can, if you think it makes sense.
Maybe not.
You could save it for your attack too, though, because you're gonna do.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to attack too.
Yeah. What is she just plus one damage, right?
Yeah, she does plus one damage to everybody for everything. Yay!
There's no bonus for me.
But that's fine. It doesn't do a negative to you either.
That's 3 damage.
So now he's at 6
damage. I've never drawn the Eldritch Token before today. Of course, it does nothing for my character most of the time. I have one action left.
Oh, what are you going to do?
I'm going to draw again.
All right. Why the hell not?
Oh, no.
What'd you get?
-3. So I was at 4, 5, 6.
-3, it gets you down to 3. Do you have anything that gives you a bonus if, like, a fast and loose, fast play or anything?
Nothing.
Ugh.
So he attacks me back. He does 2 and 2.
So he might be killing off somebody.
He's killing Dr. Milan Christopher. And so I take 1 damage and 1 brain.
No, you don't, because he has 2 brains and one.
But he already had 1 brain.
Right.
So he had 1 and 1 left.
Oh, so you have to take 1 of 1.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. And that's it. I think that's our entire turn.
That's our entire turn. So he is the hunter, so he gets to hit.
Hunter, he's going to attack the player with the highest combat, which is me. So he does 2 brains.
Oh, God.
And 2 damage. Now, I can use first aid.
Okay.
So next turn I could
heal yourself.
Heal myself if it seems like I need to.
Okay.
I probably will, one of my actions.
All right. Then it's upkeep phase.
Yep.
Now I get the kitty. There's yours, here's mine.
Okay.
Okay.
Whew, this is rough. Top of the round?
Top of the round, 1 mythos card. Mythos. Ancient evils, it's an omen. Place 1 doom on the current agenda. Grrrrg.
Icy ghoul. Oh, he spawns in the cellar.
Oh, so he's gone.
He's gone.
He doesn't exist.
Well, technically he's down there.
Oh, really?
He's down there.
So we don't get the cellar now?
We never get those, by the way.
But we do get the hit points, though, for it.
We get the victory points if there's no clue tokens on it at the end of the game.
Okay, but there aren't.
Yeah. So he spawns in the cellar, which means he's going to move into the hallway. Because he's a ghoul.
Eventually.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, we might kill this guy
and
then
turn,
run.
Right now.
Okay. So, I don't have this anymore. Thank God. So what I can do is... damage myself.
Okay.
And that gives him 1 damage.
So he's at 7. He has 3 hit points left.
And then I'm going to do this.
Did we put a doom token?
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
That's why this one is green.
Oh.
Not the other way, because I am stupid. All right, not really. But anyway, so... that was 1. I'm going to do this as 2, and that will change it from fight to willpower. I already did that. Never mind. All right, and then, whatever, and it doesn't matter. Okay, so then I'm going to spin this, which gets me 5. And then I'm going to do, let's see, he is a what? A 4?
He's a 4. Now she gives you +1.
She gives me +1, so that gets me 6.
No, she doesn't. It's +1 fight.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So fine. I can't use her.
But you do get +1 damage. But...
yeah. Okay. This does not give me any plus.
So you just
actually deals +1 damage as well, so I just need the 3.
Yeah,
I
so
need
you
to win.
You need 3.
So, 1. Say, so 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yep. And that puts you 4 ahead.
8. And that's all I need, right?
Well, that's all you need, yep.
Okay, so I'm going to do that.
And that's it. You're about to shrivel his head.
We'll see. And I got a -2, which means he's a dead dog. Because this is +1, I have a +1, and she has a +1, he's gone.
Yep.
He is demolished.
Done.
Is that actually finished? Did we actually win, or do we have to leave?
Okay, well, let's see. Now we get to flip it.
Yay! We haven't been able to do this before.
When the robed creature falls, the fiendish swarm burrows back into the ground, and the chaos of the house quiets. But the stranger in your parlor doesn't seem relieved. "You broke my seal that was set to trap the ghouls within,"
She raises her torch. Now we must take more direct measures and burn this hell pit to the ground. So I have to decide. It was never much of a home. Burn it down. Or this hell pit is my home. No way are we burning it. Huh.
Now, did the house go back to normal so that it looks like a house, or still underground tunnels and cracks?
It says the chaos of the house quiets.
Doesn't mean that it's all of a sudden fixed.
Okay, so.
What does the R1 and R2
do? I think, this is what I think.
Okay.
If we let her burn it down,
uh-huh,
she will join us.
I think so too.
And if we tell her, no way.
She will leave.
That's okay. What I think is going to happen.
Okay.
But it's my home.
Yeah, you could just live with me. It's all good. My little rinky-dinky apartment.
Behind the cafe?
Yeah. Maybe.
As long as I get free pie.
Maybe.
All right.
Maybe
that's fine.
Get free pie.
Let's burn it down. Now we look in the book to see what happens.
Oh, boy.
This is Revelation 1. You nod and allow the red-haired woman to set the walls and floor of your house ablaze. The fire spreads quickly, and you run out the front door to avoid being caught in the inferno. From the sidewalk, you watch as everything you own is consumed by the flames. Come with me, the woman says. You must be told of the threat that lurks below. Alone, we are surely doomed. But together, we can stop it. In your campaign log, we have to record that our house was burned to the ground. I do earn the Lita Chandler card and may include it in my deck. It does not count towards deck size. The lead investigator suffers one mental trauma from watching his home become a smoldering ruin.
That's okay. You're not hurt too bad.
That means every game I have one mental damage, and I only have 4 left.
What do you mean?
That's how it works. Every game now, I'm now going to have to start with the game with 1 damage. All right, each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the display, victory display. Each investigator, that does include the seller.
Mm-hmm.
Each investigator earns 2 bonus experience from gaining insight into the hidden world of the mythos.
5 damage, or 5. We got 5.
We got 5 plus the 2?
Plus the 2 is 7.
7. Huh. And that was The Gathering, part 1 of Night of the Zealot. I've lost my home. I'm a little fractured, psyche-wise.
But we get to choose some new cards.
And we get to spend some experience and buy some new cards. We're going to do that offline, and we'll talk about it in our next game, which cards we chose.
Yes.
So with that, thank you for joining us on this journey through this pretty cool narrative-type game. And we look forward to seeing you at the next one. If you know anybody who would like this type of gameplay, game, you know, walkthrough, definitely we'd appreciate it if you shared it. We're trying to get 1,000 subscribers because that's like the big delta in YouTube land. So if you could subscribe, we'd really appreciate it. Yeah, thanks guys.
Bye.